So it's things like GCC and so on. And I'm going to close that one down now to indicate that for the time being it is installed. So let's now take a look at, looks like I think it should be this one next. I think I checked this. Let's tidy this up. So sysstat. Well, it looks like they need to be installed. Tools. Okay, so they're all the way over here. And fcron needed. MTA, oh yeah, it's getting round and roundabouts again. So, common which needed send mail, send now needed open LDAP, Soros, Sazzle, it needs Maria DB, so I think actually at the moment we can probably install that. It does say it's designed to be yeah, it's got config there. I think I'll have to leave this tab around until I'm ready to install fcron. So for now I'm going to get rid of fcron, send a mail, open LDAP, Sorosazzle and MariaDB. I'm going to install NetTools, which I'm going to move right after package I want to install, which one was it? OpenSSH, wasn't it? Yeah, so let's stick that there instead. So let's do sysTools next, sysstat, sorry. Take a look at this. Got okay, there's nothing to change there. So let's build this. Okay, and install it with make install. Okay, that's complete. And I'm going to move this tab right to the very beginning. Don't know how far I can drop that. There it is. All the way back here. Looks like I've opened some tabs several times. And if I remember, there was another one I needed to put in for cron, and that's make CA, so I'll load that up as well. And then I know those two are for installation, sorry, not fcron, make CA. Not installation, the configuration needs to be done afterwards. So the only thing I've got to do with this one, apart from the config in fcron, is this bit here. So I'll become root again, cd BLFS boot scripts, and make sysstat. And I could, in fact, start that now. So that started. So I need to just do this bit for cron with that one. And the same with make CA is the cron job, which is there. A bit there. So now I'm going to go back to NetTools. Let me just check I haven't got this anywhere else. There seems to be a few duplicates. No, NetTools. Did I mark off sysstat? No, I didn't. So I'll put an R against that after fcron has been installed. Okay, so now I'm going to save. Okay, so this goes into, all right, it's SourceForge, so I need to open it in a new, I'll open a new window. Hasn't started yet. Is it going to start? There it is. Save NetTools 2.0. So I can shut that down now. Come back out of here and extract it. So there's an option there to take the interactive configuration process. I'm just going to accept the defaults. So it's just a case of copying all of this, pasting that in, and waiting for it to finish. Okay, and then as the root, install it, and that's done. So that's chapter 15, sorry, networking programs, and it's NetTools. So that's complete, that doesn't need to be revisited. So I'll shut that one down. To tidy up here. And now move on to OpenSSH. So we've got GDB for tests, Linux, we've got the X Windows system working, obviously, because we're using it, looking at it. Mit Kerberos not being used, and all the others are outside of the book. We've got a JDK, although this is pointing to the source, the binary one we've got should work for now. We've got NetTools and Systat installed now, so let's save this. So first of all, we need to install a user and a group for SSH to use. Okay, come out of root and we can build a package. Let's just check some of these options here. I'm just going to copy this at the moment. Cross-reference some of these. So sysconf dir, md5 passwords, default path, wispam. So we need to add wispam because we've got pam installed. It makes sense to use it. With xauth. Right, set the default location for XAuth binary for XAuth. You can omit this switch if XAuth is already installed, okay? We haven't got Kerberos and we haven't got libedit, so that's a good configuration to go with. Just adding wispam. Okay, there's a result there of the configs. We'll just check. We've got PAM support, so that's good. I don't think there's anything of particular interest there other than that. So let's build it. Right, so that's finished building. Now it says to test this, we need to copy SCP from the package into the file system manually. before we run the test. We need to look at user bin for a program called SCP, and you can see there isn't one there at the moment, so we're not going to overwrite anything as it suggests might be possible. So we need to copy, is it in this directory? Looks like it is. Let's actually list it. Yes, it's an executable, so scp user bin, and we need to be the root to do that. That's done. So now we can run the tests, and I can only run one thread by the looks of it, so it might take a little bit of time. Let's time it anyway. Run the tests and see what happens. Okay, so that has passed after 35 minutes. If I can see, everything, yeah, all unit tests passed. So that's good. So it's become root to do the installation. Copy all these commands here. Some configuration to do here. So this will prevent anybody logging in as root. If you have a need to do this, to log in as root, then just modify the no in this line to yes to allow it. There's some information there about logging in without typing password using like key exchange. I won't go into that now. And if you want to start the SSH server at system boot, then you need to start this. Now, it's quite a useful thing to have SSH, because if, for example, you're in graphics environment and the screen goes, either it corrupts or something happens, you can't see what's happening, but the computer seems to be alive, you can confirm it by trying to make a connection from a remote terminal into the one you're having problems with. And obviously if it responds, at least you've got a chance to maybe shut down the computer or reboot it or, you know, do some maintenance or whatever. So it's quite useful to have. So I'm going to go into the BLFS boot scripts, run this make install SSHD, which means it will start up and shut down the server when the machine's powered on and shut down. I'm now going to start this server up. Start, and as the root user, as a normal user, I'm going to do SSH, and I'm explicitly going to type in the loopback IP address, and should allow me to connect, basically loopback into this computer and test it, and it is running. And if I do ps minus a, yes, there is all the processes being run by Kernotex, and you can see there is my SSH session that is running, and only a few processes later the PS command that I just ran, and you can see there's all the other processes running, the initial bash, the startex, the xinit that started the Windows, and the xterm and the actual window manager running. For some reason Falcon's not there. I don't know why that is. But anyway, so if I now do Control D to log out, it closes the connection. If I do PS minus A again, you can see that it's now closed down that SSH. So that proves that SSH is working. And the final way to prove it would be to access it actually from a separate remote machine. Which I'm not going to do now because that's not the point of this. It is just to install OpenSSH for another package, and I can't remember which one. So I'll tidy that up. I don't think this is a package that needs to be rebuilt, as I remember. No, it looks okay. So chapter 4 security again. Once again, we're going back to chapter 4, the original chapter, and crossing off another package. So I'll shut that down now.